Hello everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Instrumentation and Control. Today's our topic is Lapnau Stability Theorem in the Unit Number 4, Fuzzy Logic Application in the Control System. Now, as you study the Lapnau Stability that you have to study in the Control System Design, so first of all, what is the Lapnau Stability? So this is applicable for both linear and the non-linear system. If we have to find the stability for the particular system, it is linear or the non-linear, that time we have to use the Lapnau Stability criteria. Now, how to differentiate that this type of system will be linear or the non-linear? So if the behavior of the system is same every time, so that type of system is known as the linear system. If behavior will be changed at every time, that time this type of system is known as the non-linear system. So linear system always obey the superposition theorem. Okay, so the Lapnau stability is applicable all type of the system. So how Lapnau stability is applicable for the linear and the non-linear system? So for that we have to take one example. We have to take one system G of S. U of T is the input signal that is applied to the system G of S, and Y1 of T is my output signal for this particular system. Next system is we have to change the input signal U2 of T. The system will be as it is, so we can get the output Y2 of T. Clear? Now, if we have to apply the input signal alpha 1 U of T, and we can get alpha 1 Y of T. And if we have to change the input alpha 2 Y of T, Y2 of T, we can get the output alpha 2 Y2 of T. So, in the linear system, if we add multiple inputs for the same plant, we can get the fixed output. Okay, if U1T is input, and if we can get the Y1 of the output, and U2 of the, if we can get Y2 of the output, that time if we have to add two input U1T plus U2T, we can get the output like this manner, Y1 of T plus Y2 of T. So here the summarized equation is like that: alpha 1 U1 of T plus alpha 2 U2 of T, we can get the output alpha 1 Y1 of T plus alpha 2 Y2 of T. So the Lapnau theorem is applicable linear as well as the non-linear system. So in general, if we have to write the equation for the linear system, we have to write in this form, x dot, that is equal to dx by dt, is equal to function of the x and the u, where the value of the x and u are of the in the first order. Okay, now we have to take one example. So here, very simple example, a simple harmonic damped oscillator is given. This is a one type of mechanical system where mass is given, damper is given, and spring constant K is given, and displacement x is given. Here they will be specified as force that is equal to zero. Okay, so if we have to write the equation for this particular mechanical system, so we have to write mass into acceleration, and acceleration is nothing but the d square x upon dt square. So m into d square x upon dt square plus b into v, and v is equal to dx upon dt. So v into dx by dt plus k into x, and force that is equal to zero. So we can put here is equal to zero. Now we have to assume the state variable x1 that is equal to x, and x2 is equal to x dot. Okay, so we can put the state variable in the above equation. We can get x1 dot that is equal to x2, okay, and x2 dot that is equal to here minus b by m x2 minus a by m x1. This is my equation number 1 for this particular mechanical system. If we have to draw the state transition matrix, so we can get x dot, that is equal to x1 dot x2 dot is equal to, here you can see that in the x1 dot only x2 terminal, x2 element is there, so we can put x1 that is equal to 0, x2 that is the coefficient of x2 is 1, so we can put here 1. For x2 dot, what is the coefficient of x1? It is minus k by m. And what is the coefficient of x2? It is minus b by m. And another matrix x1, x2. So, the system is linear as all the value of x1 dot and u in the right side of the equation, that means they are to the first power only. So using the Lapunov stability, we have to identify the system is linear and the non-linear and it is stable or the unstable. Okay. So if it is non-linear, for a non-linear system, these terms are in the product form, powers form or product of xi. Okay. So we can get the equation like this manner, x1 dot x2 or the x1 square or the sin x1. So if we can get the term like this manner, so this type of system becomes non-linear system. Clear? So this is the difference between linear equation and the non-linear equation. Okay, now take another example to identify that the system is non-linear. Okay, so example is given, a swinging pendulum, and the equation of the pendulum is given x double dot plus g by l sin x that is equal to 0, where x is the angle of the pendulum from the vertical. Now what is g and what is l? So as you know, g is the acceleration due to the gravity and l is the length of the pendulum. Okay, now same thing we have to apply. We have to assume the state variable. So we can take x1 that is equal to x and x2 is equal to x dot that is equal to v. So we can write the equation like this, x1 dot that is equal to x2 and x2 dot that is equal to minus g by l sin x. Clear? So thus it's a non-linear system because in this equation the term sin x is given. So sin x1 is given and the solution of the sin x1 is very difficult. So if we can use the small angle, we have to take the small angle approximation, like sin x is approximating the x for x less than equal to 1, which will linearize the equation. Okay, so if this type of equation is given, it is difficult to solve. But if there is required to solve this equation, for that we have to take the value of the x1 is less than 1 and we have to try that this non-linear system is become a linear system. Clear? Next topic is equilibrium point. Okay, a state of an autonomous system is an equilibrium state if starting at the state of the system will not move from it in the absence of the forcing input. Okay, so we have to find the equivalent point for this particular system, and equation for the equivalent point is x dot that is equal to function of x of t, u of t, t, and function of x c 0 t that is equal to 0, where the t greater than equal to t 0. Okay, so this is a simple example to find out the equivalent point. They will given the value of x dot that is equal to 0 1 minus 2 minus 3 x plus 1 1 u of t. Now we have to take u of t that is equal to 0 using this equation. Okay, so we can get 0 1 minus 2 minus 3 x1 e x2 e that is equal to 0. So we can get the equivalent point at the 0 value. Okay, so an equilibrium state xc of an autonomous system is stable in the sense of the Lapunov theory if delta epsilon greater than 0. So this is the condition of the stable condition. X0 minus X e less than delta tends to xt x0 minus xt less than zeta at t greater than t0. Okay, so an equivalent state xc is known as the equilibrium state of an autonomous system is asymptotically stable if the first condition is it is stable and it exists delta a if x0 minus xc less than delta n and xt minus xe tends to 0 as the tree tends to infinite. So the first condition for this table, so this is the equation or the condition of this table and this is the asymptotically stable. Okay, now in the asymptotically stable, as you know, on the eigenvalue of the system has a negative real part. That means left hand plane. Okay, because whenever the system is asymptotically stable, we can get the value in the imaginary axis. Now, what is the stable system condition that we have to study in the control system? All the transfer function poles or zero, that will be lies in the LHS. Okay, if any poles and zero will be located in the right hand plane, that type of system will become unstable system. Okay, so asymptotically stable in large, globally asymptotically stable. If the system is asymptotically stable for all the initial state, the equilibrium point is said to be asymptotically or exponentially stable in the large. So it is also called the globally asymptotically stable. So if the system is asymptotically stable for all initial state, so that type of system is known as the globally asymptotically stable. Okay, so this is the stability condition for the Lapnos theorem. The first one is initial condition is given and the value of the x will be varying in the circle. So this type of stable system is known as the asymptotically stable. The second condition is the value of the x of t will be vary from initial condition and go back to the initial condition. So this type of stability is known as the asymptotically stable at large. And the third condition, if the value of the x will be vary out of the circle, so that type of system is known as the unstable system. Clear? Okay, so there are some condition is given for the Lapnos theorem. So first is Vx greater than 0 for x not equal to 0 and Vx is equal to 0 for all the value of Vx is the positive defined function. The second condition is Vx is continuous partial derivation with respect to all the component of x. And the fourth condition is the equivalent state xc that is equal to 0 of the system is, the first condition is asymptotically stable if vx less than 0, x not equal to 0, that means v dot x is negative defined. The first condition is there, vx greater than 0, that time the vx is positive defined, and if vx, the value of vx is less than 0, that time it is negative definite. And the second condition is asymptotically stable in the large if v dot x less than 0, x not equal to 0 and vx tends to infinite for x tends to infinite. Okay, so you have to remember only three things. If value of the vx greater than or equal to 0, it is positive definite, and if value of the Vx is less than 0, it is negative definite and the stability is asymptotically stable in the large. And the Vx will be depends, will be partial derivation with respect to all the component of the x. Clear? Now, what is the positive definite? What is the negative definite of the Vx? So, it is known as the scalar function of the stability. So the first scalar function is positive definiteness of Vx. कि इफ द स्केलर फंक्शन vx इज सेड टू बी पॉजिटिवली फाइनाइट इन द रीजन व्हिच इंक्लूड द ओरिजिन ऑफ द स्टेट स्पेस इफ द वैल्यू ऑफ vx ग्रेटर देन 0 फॉर ऑल नॉन जीरो स्टेट एंड इफ vx इज इक्वल टू 0. ओके, व्हाट इज द negative definite of vx? Vx is negative definite where the value of vx is minus vx. That means the value of vx is less than 0. Now, positive semi-definites, if vx is positive for some state and vx is equal to 0 for some other state, that time it is known as the positive semi-definite. Same thing, negative semi-definite. If minus vx is positive semi-definite, that time vx is become negative semi-definite and indefinite of vx. If vx is both the condition positive and semi-negative definite, that time this type of system or function becomes indefinite function. Okay, so we have to use 5 type of scalar function: positive definite, negative definite, positive semi-definite, negative semi-definite, and vx have both the function positive and negative, so it is known as the indefinite. So these are the example given for the positive and the negative definite. If the value of vx is x1 square plus x2 square, and if we have to change the different value of x1 and x2, and if we can get the answer will be greater than 0 or equal to 0, so it is known as the positive definite. So you have to put in the first equation different value of x1 and x2, and you have to check. So the answer is positive definite. Okay, same equation number 2, x1 of square plus x2 of square upon 1 plus x2 of square. Okay, again we have to put the value of x and x2, and we have to check if the answer is greater than 0 or equal to 0, it is positive definite. Okay, now in the third condition, x1 plus x2 whole square, what is the condition of positive semi-definite? In the positive semi-definite, if the vx is positive for some state and vx is equal to 0 is for some other state. Okay, so it is, the answer is in the form of positive semi-definite. In the fourth equation, minus x1 of square minus bracket x1 plus x2 whole square. So if we have to change the different value of x1 and x2, the answer is negative. So we can get vx less than 0. So it is known as the negative definite. And the last one is x1 x2 plus x2 square. So the answer is indefinite. What is the indefinite? Vx is both positive and negative. Then it is indefinite. That means we can get the value of vx greater than 0, equal to 0, as well as less than 0. Okay, so these are the example given to differentiate the scalar function. Clear? Now the next one is the real symmetric matrix and is positive definite. Okay, we have to define some system that it is positive or negative definite. So a function of vx is quadratic function when it is expressed as vx that is equal to x transform p into x, where p is a real symmetric matrix and x is equal to x1 x2 up to xn. And as you know, what is the x transform? x1 x2 and xn. So this is the equation to find out that whatever matrix is given, it is positive definite or the negative definite. Okay, so a matrix P is the real symmetrical if its row and columns are the same. Okay, if we have to take the example third order system, so here 3x3 matrix is given, P is equal to P11, P12, P13, P12, P22, P23, P31, P22 and P32 and P33. So it is the real symmetrical matrix Now we have to take one example, so you have to easily identify that it is the positive definite or the negative definite. Okay, so here example, P matrix is given 10, 1, minus 2, 1, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, 1. Okay, now we have to apply the principle of minus. So first of all, we have to take only 1 cross 1 element. So we can take 10. It is greater than 0? Yes. Mod of 10 will be greater than 0. Now we have to take 2 cross 2 matrix. So mod of 10, 1 and 1, 4. We have to simplify this more. So 10 into 4, that is equal to 14, minus 1, that is equal to 39. It is also greater than 0. And then we have to take 3 cross 3 matrix. So mod of 10, 1, minus 2, 1, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, 1. We have to simplify this mode and we have to check the answer is greater than 0, equal to 0 or less than 0. So if we have to solve this mode, we can get the answer greater than 0. So P is known as the positive definite. That means the matrix or the real symmetrical matrix given in this example will be a positive symmetric. If we can apply a principle of minus and if we can get the answer is equal to 0 or less than 0, that time if it is equal to 0, P is also a positive definite, and if it is less than 0, the P matrix is known as the negative definite. Okay, so using the condition of V of X and using the equation of Vx, that is equal to x transform Px, we can easily identify that whatever system is given, it is positive definite, negative definite, positive semi-definite, negative semi-definite or undefinite. And as well as the system will be linear system or the non-linear system. Okay, now in the next session, we will study about how the Lapnos theorem will be applicable for the continuous LTI system and the discrete LTI system. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt regarding this topic, you have to contact me in my email ID.